813 right now, Florida is second worst in the nation for fraud and identity theft. So how can you protect your identity and your money? Sherry Olafson is a lawyer and author of The Great American Do-Over, and she's joining us now with some insight on how to spot a scam. First of all, thank you for being here. And secondly, how do we spot a scam? How can people avoid it?
Well, and that's a real important question right now, John, for people, particularly in South Florida, where we are number one in the nation for identity fraud. It's crazy. It's crazy. But there are some easy things that people can do that will help avoid most of those situations. First and foremost is being really careful with who you trust. Be careful to vet out a professional. Make sure that it's a local professional. Make sure it's someone you can meet. And I highly recommend actually asking to go to their office, because a lot of these scammers don't even have offices. They're knocking door to door. And if you go to the office, you can do a lot of that due diligence we know we should be doing, but we're not. Like checking for the staff, checking for licenses and diplomas on the wall, and maybe even talking to some of the other customers there who can be your references, right? The second thing is be very wary about fees. Upfront fees is one of the ways that these scammers get a hand on your money. Yeah, absolutely. So, and in some of these areas, it's even against the law. I mean, for modification companies, you can't be charging an upfront fee. Third is make sure you get everything in writing. Make sure that you don't sign anything that has any blanks on it or anything that you don't really understand. Those are all really important keys.
We're very trusting as a community. I mean, you know, it's like, it's almost easy to get scammed, but you're right. You need to. What are some other red flags that you ought to be on the lookout for?
Well, the red flags, and here are two of the most popular scams now, new scams. One is new account fraud, where people get a hold of your information and open up new accounts without you realizing it. $17 billion in that industry. And the other is what we call friendly fraud, where it's actually people that you know, so you need to be aware of that. But if you keep your eye out for other red flags, like inflated property values in a real estate transaction, especially if you're in a distressed situation and trying to get out, or missing information, inaccurate information, undisclosed dollar amounts on closing statements, those types of things, you can avoid getting yourself in a lot of trouble.
All right, so now it's happened. What should you do now that you've fallen victim to a scam?
Definitely, that's a great question. Definitely report it. The Federal Trade Commission has a number that you can call. The Florida Attorney General has a number you can call. And you know that consumer awareness actually helped reduce credit card fraud by 38% last year.
Oh, that's excellent.
It pays to be aware.
That's right. And do report it. All right. Well, thank you very much for being here once again. We'll see you next time
around. Thanks. Have a great week.
All right, Sherry. Roxanne, back over to you.
Time now for a look at weather.